Welcome back to the channel, everybody. And we're in an epic location and we're joined by an equally epic car, the Renault 5 GT Turbo. But this isn't just any GT Turbo, it's the Raider version, which was available only in 1990. So being the Raider version, you get the different paint scheme, different interior, and although these are different wheels now, it had different wheels as well as that. It was only available over here in the UK and it didn't get any more power than the standard model. The standard model was available between 1985 and 1991, and this particular special edition was bought out just to see off the closing year of this model. So engine wise it's got 1.4 carbureted engine, no fuel injection here. It's got a turbo, amazing. It's got a whole eight valves, and produces 120 horsepower in its day. This one, however, has had some more modern touches put on it. So got more modern turbo, top end's been rebuilt as well. So it's a lot more drivable, a bit more power as well, thanks to the stainless steel exhaust, a tune, and obviously that turbo. So we're upwards of 130 horsepower now. I think it looks amazing. These have aged really well. We've got Alpina GTA wheels as well, which look really cool. I think the next thing to do now, Scott, is take it for a little drive and let you lovely people hear it. Well, we're inside the Renault 5 GT Turbo Raider Edition. Absolute dream boat. You can hear there's a few rattles. You can definitely tell it's, as we say in the motor trade, en français. Generally, French cars around this era just have rattles, it's part of their quirks. It's just simply the plastic they're made out of and stuff like that. Less is more, bit of a Lotus philosophy there. But yeah, driving position, very nice, very nice. The seats are very comfortable, well bolstered. I'm sitting quite low, which is very good. And the throttle's quite stiff. Again, there's many linkages going on because it is a carbureted vehicle, so that means, yeah, it's just part and parcel of it. How are you over there, Scott? Have a nice time?
Yeah, very nice.
Brilliant, brilliant. Yeah, so we're in some nice little B roads now. Obviously, you can probably hear by everything that's going on in here that we're on some B roads. But that's where these types of cars really come alive. It's all about the feel. And they're just very nostalgic. Obviously, this is the max power era, late 80s, early 90s. This is when all hot hatches and stuff like this were the absolute rage. Twocking, taking without consent, stealing stuff. Wow, there's a lovely little bend here. We'll send it through. Ooh. And it starts to come on boost about just before 3000 RPM. So it's, yeah, it's responsive for something like this. And even though it's a 1.4, it's plenty of pep, like it's enough what you need for a car that's this light. This is about 830 kilos, which is super light. I think, downshift, sender through, thread the needle. As you can tell, I'm having a lovely time. Yeah, because they're so short and the wheels are out at each corner, they're just extremely nimble and agile. They're just a really fun car. It definitely feels like an event. We're not going particularly fast, but because there's not much around us, and what is around us is very thin, it's definitely adding to the experience. Such a cool thing. Yeah, the gearbox is silky smooth. This is quite a low mileage example as well. It's just done 80,000 miles, which for a 1990 car is very low mileage. It's been very well looked after as well. Paintwork's very nice, engine bay is lovely. It's got a different turbo, recent remap as well, different intercooler I saw under the bonnet as well. I am just going on what I've seen because the spec sheet on this is very, very vague. I'll let you into a secret, I don't know much about Renault 5 turbos, which you can probably tell, but they are like an icon. beans. Yeah, as I said, 130 horsepower is enough. Like, it's just fun. We're on like an open road now, and it reminds me of that time at the beach when I had the towel incident. I feel very exposed. I feel like crumple zones my legs because my legs are touching the steering wheel. And there's not much around us in here, is there, Scott? But yeah, it's just really fun. It's just quirky. And we're back. Respect to your bad self. I can definitely tell why Ali G love these so much. They are a proper cool car. The Renault 5 GT Turbo. So what's it like to drive? Driving it on open roads, like big, long, modern open roads, i.e. a motorway, it is a bit rattly, it's comfortable, but it could be more comfortable. You definitely feel like you're working the car a bit more than you need to, but as soon as you get it onto B roads, like we have plenty around here, it just all makes sense. The steering feel, how you can nip it through corners just because it's so short and nimble. Like, these only weigh about 830 kilos, and with a little over 130 horsepower in it, it's plenty. Like, I have a massive smile on my face from driving it, and it's just proper cool. I've not had the luxury of driving many of these, and this is the best one I've driven. Obviously, it is a special edition, so it has the nice color scheme, the different interior, and it is that bit extra special. But what's your favorite 80s hot hatch? Is it a Nova? Is it a 205? Is it the Renault 5? Let us know in the comments. But Renault 5 GT Turbo, obviously it's got a turbo, so you get all the extra noises, which obviously heighten that whole experience. So yeah, hopefully you've enjoyed watching this. We're gonna do a few more in-depth reviews on extra special cars, and believe me, this is an extra special car. So let us know if you see anything on our site that you want that of. Thank you very much to Dream Cars. Thank you, Scott, for being passenger princess today, and we'll see you on the next one.